नमो ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो ऋषिभ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरितः प्रज्ञान घन प्रत्यगर्तो ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि। नारायणं पद्मभुवं वसिष्ठं शक्तिञ्च तत्पुत्रपराशरञ्च व्यासं शुकं गौडपदं महान्तं गोविन्दयोगीन्द्रमथास्य शिष्यं श्रीशङ्कराचार्यमथास्य पद्मपादञ्च हस्तावलकञ्च शिष्यं तन्तोटकं वार्तिककारमन्यानस्मद्गुरून् सन्ततमानतोऽस्मि। श्रुतिश्रुतिप्राणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहना भवतु, सहनौ भुनक्तु, सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यद्ब्रह्मगोचरविचित्रतमः प्रभावात् संसारदीजनितदुःखमभूज्जनस्य यद्ब्रह्मदीजनितसौख्यमभूच्च तस्य तं रुक्मिणीसहितकृष्णमहं नमामि। यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकजाङ्कमनन्तसुखाकृतिम्। We were at the Tritiya Paksha. So the third Vikalpa as to why Adhyasa is not possible, whether it is Ayukta, Ayuktatvadva, Abhanadva, Karanabhavadva, these are the three options which the Siddhanti gave Purvapakshi as to why Adhyasa is not possible. If it is Ayukta, illogical, we say yes, it is illogical, but it is Anubhava Siddha. Therefore, second option, Abhanadva, is also refuted because there is Anubhava of Manushyaham, Ajnyaham, Ityadi, Baddhuham. Then, what about the third option? Karana for Adhyasa is lacking. So, Karana Bhavadva, that is refuted here. How so? Etena, what was said in Ratnaprabha, etena karana bhavaditi kalpa, kalpa is vikalpa, nirastaha, karana bhavad, adhyasaha na sambhavati. But karanam tu asti eva, shows the siddhanti. How so? Samskarasya nimittasya naisargika padena uktatvat. Bhagavan Bhashyakara said, naisargiko ayam lokavyavahara. Lokavyavahara also shows twofold adhyasa, arthadhyasa and jnanadhyasa. Thereby, nimitta karana has been shown. There is a nimitta. So, karana bhavad cannot be said because naisargika anubhava is there. Naisargika padena nimitta karanasya uktatva. Nimitta karana has been mentioned. Samskara is there. Adhyasa samskara is there and that leads to another adhyasa. Therefore, adhyasya mithunikritya lokavyavaharaha. And what is that lokavyavahar? Naisargikaha. Ayam lokavyavahar. Ayam shows that it is anubhava siddha. And naisargika shows that there is samskara. And that samskara is a nimitta karana. Therefore, there is no abhava of karana for adhyasa. टीका सो विकल्प तृतीय पक्ष इत्यर्थ एतत् शब्दार्थं हेतु विवृणोति। सो व्हाट इज द हेतु देयर? संस्कार 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 रूप निमित्त कारणस्य संस्कार रूप निमित्त कारणस्य इत्यर्थः। सो संस्कारस्य निमित्तस्य मीन्स व्हाट? संस्कार रूप निमित्त कारण। व्हाट इज निमित्त? संस्कार इज निमित्त, मीनिंग व्हाट? संस्कार इज निमित्त कारण, मीनिंग निमित्त कारण इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ संस्कार। देयर बाय, सो निमित्त कारण, देयर आर टू कारण, निमित्त एंड उपादान कारण। नाउ निमित्त कारण हैज बीन इंडिकेटेड, बट इट इज नॉट ओनली निमित्त कारण विच इज इंडिकेटेड। अध्यास इज रिवील्ड as being something that is the cause for, hetu for samskara, and samskara becomes the cause for adhyasa. Now further, samskara rupa nimitta karanasya ityartha samskara hetu purvadhyasasya idam upalakshanam. It is also an upalakshana for samskara hetu also. So not only is samskara karana, but paramparaya adhyasa, purvadhyasa is also karana, because samskara, when you say, then samskara left by what? Therefore it is an upalakshana to include the samskara hetu, which is what? Purvadhyasa. Tasya api idam upalakshanam. Tatha cha samskara tadhetu, samskara tadhetu adhyasa yor. नैसर्गिक पदेन उक्तत्वात् विकल्पः निरस्तः इति भावः. Thereby, samskara along with its hetu, which is the purvadhyasa, both are meant by saying naisarga, naisargika. So naisargika pada in the bhashya includes both the samskara as well as indicates samskara as well as its hetu, samskara hetu, which is purvadhyasa. Thereby, कारणाभावाद अध्यास न संभवति, दैट पक्ष इज ऑल्सो निरस्त, इट इज रिफ्यूटेड. रत्न प्रभा न च पूर्व प्रमाजन्य एव संस्कार हेतुरिति वाच्यम. सो न च पूर्व प्रमाजन्य एव संस्कार, द संस्कार विच वॉज ऑब्जेक्टेड एट द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द ग्रंथ. वाई इज अध्यास नॉट पॉसिबल? ही सेज नेवर हैव यू had Atma and Anatma Anubhava together, meaning as one. If there is no Aikya Anubhava, Yathartha Anubhava, why? Because Tamav Prakashava Viruddha Swabhava. Both are Tamav Prakasha Viruddha Swabhava, just like you do not have Aikya Yathartha Anubhava between Tamah and Prakasha, darkness and light. Similarly here, in Atma and Anatma, there cannot be oneness. Why? That Adhyasa. Can it be adhyasa? Adhyasa also cannot be there. There cannot be Brahma between Atma and Anatma being one. Why? Because it expects a Purva Samskara. And that Samskara should be Yathartha Jnana Janya. Yathartha Jnana, Yathartha Anubhava of Atma and Anatma being one was never there. And if it was never there, then Samskara is lacking. Then how do you say Samskara is Nimitta Karana? So karana bhavad still holds good, because samskara that you claim to be there is adhyasa janya. It is ayathartha brahma janya samskara, natu prama janya samskara. So siddhanti remembers this. He says nacha purva prama janya eva samskara heturiti vachyam. Kasya hetu? Adhyasasya. So adhyasa karana has to be that samskara which is purva prama janya, Yathartha Anubhava Janya. Don't say that. That is not a valid objection. Why? Laghavena. Laghavena Purva Anubhava Janya Samskarasya Hetutvat. If Samskara is there, that leads to Brahma, Adhyasa. Now, whether that Samskara is Brahmajanya or Brahmajanya, meaning Yathartha Anubhava Janya, यथार्थ ज्ञान जन्य और अयथार्थ अनुभव जन्य, अयथार्थ ज्ञान जन्य इज नॉट एट ऑल द डिस्कशन. दैट इज नॉट इवन एक्सपेक्टेड. व्हाई? बिकॉज यू लुक एट व्हाट इज द कॉज. वेदर द संस्कार इज ड्यू टू प्रमा और भ्रमा, दैट एनालिसिस इटसेल्फ इज इररिलेवेंट, बिकॉज संस्कार इज द हेतु. By upalakshana we say adhyasa is also hetu, purva adhyasa, but that purva adhyasa you cannot replace by yathartha jnana. Need not be, because samskara is sakshat karana there. Directly it is giving rise to adhyasa. Now to take an example, let's say you are tired. You have been working for weeks together and you have been tired, working on a deadline. You have not been able to sleep well. So you are sleepy, more or less sleepy एटलीस्ट फॉर सम पार्ट ऑफ द डे एट वर्क एंड देन यू आर अनेबल टू रिकॉल एज टू वेदर समथिंग रियली हैपेंड और इट हैपेंड इन अ ड्रीम. वाई बिकॉज देर इज अ संस्कार. यू हैव अ संस्कार मेमरी देयर बाय ट्रिगरिंग मेमरी सम रिकलेक्शन ऑफ समथिंग हैपेंड. Now you have been working so much day in day out that leaves an impression which gives rise to swapna also. So in work, in the more you do something in jagrat avastha, the more you get similar dreams. That is why we should do all punya karma so that in swapna also we keep on continuing these shuddha vasanas trigger shuddha swapna. So that is the idea behind doing good things throughout the day. Now when you have been working throughout the day, then the same work you carry in swapna also. You may not want to carry it home, but then in swapna it triggers. Now you get some solution, you work on something, whether or not you have done it, you don't remember. So sometime during the next day, you wonder whether you did that. Or somebody visited, somebody asked you to do something, the colleague said something, the boss said something, the subordinate, whatever it is. So imagine a scenario where you are unable to place whether, especially when you are a little drowsy, whether it really happened yesterday or it was a dream. Now why are you unable to make out the difference? Sometimes you'll say, oh, it really happened. Then you talk to your colleague and nothing like that has happened the earlier day. Therefore you are able to conclude that there was a swapna of that type. Now that swapna anubhava of colleague or boss saying something, that was brahma, that was an adhyasa, that left the samskara again which caused your brahma in the waking state the next day. So there is no niyama that this samskara should be pramajanya. In swapna you didn't have yathartha anubhava. You had a brahma, you had ayathartha anubhava, which was negated on waking up. Not in your drowsy state, let's say you didn't recollect the dream then, but then it triggered something and then in discussion it came up and your colleague said, nothing like that happened. What are you talking about? You must be dreaming. Then he says, oh yeah. Then you recollect, oh yeah, maybe it was a dream yesterday. I am unable to differentiate. So imagine that scenario, what happened there? There is some samskara, which is brahmajanya samskara, not pramajanya samskara. Still it gave rise to bhranti in the waking state. Therefore, laghavena, if you say no, the samskara also has to be purva pramajanya, that is not true. In fact, Bhagavan Gaudapadacharya in Mandukya Karika says that this hetu hetumat bhava has been continuing, but there is no real hetu there. The hetu is not due to real janma, real karma and real karma phala adrishta, which gives rise to this sharira, which is hetumat. And then this sharira, after taking the sharira, you do real karma. The sharira is real, you do real karma, and then that gives rise to some real samskaras. That is not the case, which leads to further janma. There can be a bhranti parampara also. Thereby, and I had mentioned earlier as to Vichara Sagara also concludes this as to, after inquiring, after vichara, it says that this sampradaya which is continuing samskara and then thereby kartrutva bhuktrutva that is continuing, that samsaranam itself is not due to real samskara. It is not due to something in the past that is real, therefore the current is real and therefore the future will be real. There is no such expectancy at all. Anyway, we have seen with the example as to swapna samskara also can cause sambhranti. Therefore, Siddhanti tells the Purvapakshi, Purvapramajanya eva samskaraha hetu adhyasasya hetu bhavati iti nacha vachyam. You should not object like that. Why? Laghavena. There is laghava in this. There is gaurava in your paksha. saying that now this samskara avachedaka will be purva prama. So purva prama janyatva will become avachedaka of this samskara. There will be gauratvam there. Therefore laghavena purva anubhava janya samskarasya hetutvat. There is purva anubhava janya samskara. Whether that anubhava is yatharta anubhava or ayatharta anubhava, that is invalid. That is the adhyasa hetu. Ataha purva adhyasa janya samskara asti iti siddham. Therefore purva anubhava janya samskara is definitely there. By objecting that purva the samskara should be purva yatharta anubhava janya, mean prama is what? Purva prama janya. When purva pakshi says, then he is accepting that there is samskara which is anubhava janya. What he is not accepting is that it is yatharta anubhava janya. We are not claiming it is yatharta anubhava janya, we are saying it is ayatharta anubhava janya. So now he is, now that he has accepted that samskara can be the hetu for adhyasa, but it should be yatharta, we say yatharthatvam is not needed, ayatharthatvam is also okay, then what is the end result of this discussion? Therefore ataha purva adhyasa janya samskara asti. There is purva anubhava adhyasa janya samskara. That adhyasa anubhava is there, purva adhyasa, it is ayatharta anubhava, but tajanya samskara is definitely there. Therefore karana is there, nimitta karana is there, asti iti siddham, that is established. Tika laghavena iti karanata avachedaka kutau yatharta pada visishta prama padam na niveshyate kintu brahma prama sadharana anubhava padam niveshyate. So tikakara explains as to the avachedaka. What is the avachedaka for this samskara being janya by something? Janya by what? So what is the jnana janya? It is jnana janya or anubhava janya. Jnana means anubhava. So what kind of jnana, what kind of anubhava? In that kota, in the sense, in that lakshana, see what kind of samskara? Samskara should be pramajanya or brahmajanya. It is anubhava janya for both parties. Now that anubhava should be qualified. What is the visheshana to that? So that visheshana will become avachedaka. So here it says karanata avachedaka. Samskara is karana and samskara karana is earlier anubhava. So there karanata avachedaka koto yatharta pada visishta pramapadam na niveshyate. This yatharta pada visishta pramapadam. Prama is what? Yatharta anubhava. So in the prama, when you say purva pramajanya samskara, there the jnana or anubhava is not qualified by pramarupa jnana or anubhava, meaning yatharta pada visishta prama. Prama is yatharta pada visishta anubhava. So you don't have that qualifier, you don't have that visheshana yatharta pada. Why? Anubhava janya, not yatharta anubhava janya. Na niveshyate, that is not there in the lakshana. Kintu brahma prama sadharana anubhava padam. Only anubhava is needed. What is that anubhava? When you don't qualify the anubhava, it will include all sorts of anubhava. Whether it is real or unreal is irrelevant. So it can be brahma anubhava also, it can be prama anubhava also. That will leave, definitely anubhava will leave a samskara. Whether it is brahma or prama, both anubhavas will leave samskara. Therefore brahma prama sadharana anubhava padam niveshyate. Tataha adhishthana samanya aropya visheshyoho visheshayoho adhishthana samanyayo samanya adhishthana samanya. So in the rajata, shukti rajata, shukti has rajata adhyasa. This is rajata, idam rajatam. When you say idam rajatam, idam belongs to shukti and rajata is adhyasta. So adhishthana samanya is idam. Adhishthana is shukti. So shukti samanya is what? Idam. Samanya इज नोन, इजम इज नोन, बट विशेष्य इज नॉट नोन, शुक्ति इज नॉट नोन. Therefore, we don't say इयम शुक्ति, we'll end up saying इदम रजतम. Thereby, आरोप्य विशेष्य रजत इज आरोप्य. आरोप्य विशेषयोः ऐक्य अनुभव जनित संस्कारत्वं कारणत्वं. We have had such अनुभव earlier, some kind of अनुभव of इदम, which is अधिष्ठान सामान्य. That अधिष्ठान need not be शुक्ति in the earlier अनुभव which leads to this अध्यासा, that इदम रजतम can be in the प्रमास्थला also. Pramasthala meaning, in the shop also you could have had idam rajatam anubhava. So idam is adhisthana samanya, which is there in shukti also. Therefore, bhranti is possible because samskara is there. Idam and rajata, which is vishesha, aropya vishesha in the brahmasthala. Earlier samskara is there, there it is pramajanya. But it need not be pramajanya also, it can be brahmajanya also. If you have seen Shukti Rajata, meaning you have seen Rajata instead of Shukti once, then it can cause a samskara, it can leave behind a samskara of Idam and Rajata being together, being one, and thereby it can lead to another Brahma later as well. Therefore, what he says is, अधिष्ठान सामान्य आरोप्य विशेषयोः ऐक्य अनुभव जनित संस्कारत्वं कारणत्वं. So in the Purvapakshi's objection, when he opened the objection at the beginning of the text, he had said that in the Shukti Rajata case, Idam and Rajatam were seen together as one in the shop or at home. You have seen real silver earlier. Therefore, there can be such Brahma. But in the case of Atma and Anatma, where have you seen them together? So we say, yes, it is true in your example case. But Brahma Janita Samskara is also possible. In your example case also, if somebody has mistaken Idam as the Shukti as Rajata, the shell as silver, then that also can lead to Samskara and Samskara Janya Brahma later. Therefore, अधिष्ठान सामान्य आरोप्य विशेषयोः ऐक्य अनुभव जनित संस्कारत्वं कारणत्वं कारणतावच्छेदकम् इति कारणतावच्छेदक लाघवेन इत्यर्थः. सो देयर इज लाघव इन अवर पक्ष वेर अनुभव इटसेल्फ अलोन इज नीडेड. अनुभव अलोन इज नीडेड, बट देयर इज नो क्वालिफिकेशन फॉर अनुभव एज टू इट शुड बी. द कारणतावच्छेदक इज ओनली अनुभव जनित संस्कार. वॉट इज दट अनुभव? इट इज सामान्य अनुभव एंड आरोप्य विशेष अनुभव. सामान्य इज वॉट अधिष्ठान. अधिष्ठान सामान्य अनुभव इज नीडेड एंड आरोप्य विशेष अनुभव इज नीडेड. समबडी हू हैज हैड सीन सिल्वर और सर्प, दैट इज डेफिनेटली एक्सपेक्टेड. सो विशेष ज्ञान इज नीडेड. यू कैनॉट हैव अनुभव ऑफ सर्प व्हेन यू हैव नेवर सीन सर्प. You should have seen Sarpa at least on National Geography or something. Some channel you'll have to have seen a picture or a photo or drawing or something. If nothing else. So that Vishesha Jnana is needed. And Adhisthana Samanya is what? Idam. That is needed. So if you have such Samagri, Adhyasa is possible. Such Samagri in Samskara, if it is there, that will lead to Adhyasa. Because this Samskara is Janya by even similar kind of anubhava earlier, which need not be atharta. Athava karana sharira lagavena ityartha. Otherwise karana sharira lagavena. Karana sharira means the lakshana itself, it becomes shorter. Tatra ajnanam ityukte. Now moving further from this topic, what has been said? Mithya jnana nimittaha ayam loka vyavaharaha. So now the Ratna Prabhakara is dealing with the commenting on the pada mithya jnana nimittaha ayam loka vyavahara. So mithya jnana nimittaha, what is this word mithya jnana nimittaha? Why mithya has been mentioned? Why ajnana has been mentioned? So Tikakara introduces that section saying tatra in the sense mithya jnana nimittaha iti pade, in that pada ajnanam iti ukte. First of all, what is mithya jnanam? Mithya jnana nimitta. There's a compound samasa which has mithya, ajnana and nimitta. There are three words. There are some who have interpreted mithya jnana nimitta. Mithya jnana, that part has been interpreted as mithya cha tat jnanam cha. Whereas in orthodoxy it is mithya cha tat ajnanam cha. So jnana is not mithya, ajnana is mithya. That is the intention of Bhagavan Bhashyakara. Of course, the other way explanation is possible, but then there are too many issues there. We'll look at that also. Meaning, when we say mithya jnana, there mithya and jnana can be the split, but that should be the secondary split. Meaning, primary will also hold good there. You cannot have mithya jnana without mithya ajnana. So even in the second paksha, you should not take mithya plus jnana is equal to mithya jnana. Although grammatically it is possible, but it is not appropriate because mithya ajnana should be there. Mithya ajnana is also being talked about, not only mithya jnana. So even if you take mithya jnana as the split, then it is mithya ajnana as well as mithya jnana. Anyway, that's an aside. Because mithya ajnana will become karana for mithya jnana, which is karya. So this is another way to look at it. I'll not revisit this. I'll leave it there. So mithya ajnana is avidya, karana, and mithya jnana is adhyasa as karya. Some take the meaning only as mithya jnana. I don't want to name anyone, but that is not appropriate. So let's come back to the topic. We follow the Vivarana Sampradaya or even Bhamari Sampradaya, but our focus should not be independent analysis. Our approach should not be independent analysis, and therefore those who oppose this earlier Sampradaya and say that it should be interpreted as mithya jnana, that can be discounted. We should take mithya jnana because there is a lot of repercussion of taking mithya jnana only without mithya jnana. So anyway, that discussion will come up as to what is ajnana itself and why mithya has been added. So introduction by Purnanandiya is tatra ajnanam ityukte jnana bhava matram ityuktam syat. So this is one repercussion, and people may not get it as to why abhava of jnana cannot be said to be the meaning of jnana, of ajnana. Avidya means lack of vidya. Ajnana means lack of jnana. Why not so? This is a common understanding. Logically, it makes sense. Tarkikas also take abhava rupa nanj in ajnana. So there are six meanings of nanj. Those who have studied Vyakrana. So sadrishya ityadi. So abhava is one meaning. So now this alpatvam, sadrishyam, abhava, and so on in these meanings, which meaning should you take for this negation, particle of negation in ajna? What does that which is a nanj particle, what does that mean? So there, common meaning that we know, rudhi artha, when you say ajnana, it means lack of jnana. And tarkikas would interpret like that, who base it on pure logic, nothing else. But if you look at a tarkika also, he talks of avava as a padartha. So even if you take abhavarte nanj, then also you will land with some bhavarupa padartha. You will land with some padartha. Ajnana is a padartha. Whereas if you take ajnana as lack of jnana, then you will be landing into shunyavada really. Because ajnana is said to be the karana. Those who take mithya jnana and not mithya ajnana and say ajnana is lack of jnana, so you don't need a separate definition for ajnana as mithya ajnana, they do not see the repercussion is that we don't have any argument with a shunyavadi. What is their solution for it? They say ajnana is not karana for anything. So if ajnana is not karana, then what is the samsara karana? They'll say it is maya. So they do not even accept that avidya and maya are interchangeable words. They say avidya is something which is there in the, they cannot even say something which is there. They'll have to say avidya is ignorance. Ignorance is not a good translation for the word ajnana. Although for a lack of better word it is used. They are used by great acharyas also. But they explain it. It is not abhava rupa. Ignorance leads to the misunderstanding that it is absence of something. So when you say I am ignorant means I do not know something. I have lack of knowledge regarding that subject. That is not the meaning of ajnana. Ajnana is bhava rupa. Yatkinchit bhava rupa. It is some padartha. It is some existent entity which is not real. But it is not unreal also. It is mithya. Therefore mithya has been added here. Jnana abhava matram iti uktam syat. It is not jnana abhava matra. Ajnana is not jnana abhava. Jnanasya abhava. Kintu mithya iti ukte. It is mithya ajnana. It is not only ajnana. If you say ajnana, ajnana should be understood as mithya ajnana. Meaning not unreal and not real also. Sarasadhyan anirvachaniya. That is the meaning of mithya shabda when you say, when Bhagavan Bhashyakara says, mithya jnana nimittaha ayam lokavyavahara. Now, if it is mithya, then why not say only mithya? Why did Bhagavan Bhashyakara say, mithya jnana nimittaha lokavyavahara? Why not? So why ajnana nimittaha? Why is it not mentioned as ajnana nimittaha lokavyavahara? Because ajnana can lead to misunderstanding that ajnana is abhavarthi nanj and therefore lack of jnana. Then why not say mithya nimitta? So mithya ityukte bhranti jnanam iti syat. Then what will happen? One will consider it as bhranti jnanam mithya. And this is the problem in splitting it as mithya jnana also. If you say mithya jnana means it will be what? Brahma, bhranti jnanam iti syat. Then Bhagavan Bhashyakara would not have added ajnana to it. He would have said mithya nimittaha. But in all his glory, he said, mithya jnana nimitta, mithya ajnana nimitta ityartha. So why both? Because tad ubhaya vyavrutya. He did not want someone to take ajnana as abhava rupa, meaning jnana, jnana abhava. And he did not want one to take the meaning as adhyasa, meaning bhranti jnana. Bhranti jnana means adhyasa, jnana adhyasa. He did not want someone to misinterpret as adhyasa also, but people have misinterpreted. And there is a whole new sampradaya followed by this kind of an interpretation. Nonetheless, ubhaya vyavrutya, to take away both of these misunderstandings, possibility of these misunderstandings, unfortunately, still it has been misinterpreted. The same sampradaya, to hint, the same sampradaya follows only bhashya. They don't follow the tika ityadi. So if you follow only the bhashya, then it is not the study of bhashya. Study of bhashya is study of tika tippana sampradaya. When you say that I have studied Upanishad, it is not just studying the Upanishad mula. Study of Upanishad mula should be from the acharya. The acharya has studied bhashya ityadi. One may not teach bhashya shabdataha, tika shabdata, but then each and every acharya in the sampradaya teaches with some basis. Teaches the basis which has been taught by earlier acharya, who has studied the bhashya tika. Now, if the mula study alone is there, meaning just the mula is explained, oh, what does this, yushmad asmad pratyay gocharayo means. So, just simple meaning if it is given, then it is just like looking up dictionaries and telling you the word meaning. That is not the idea. That is not the study of the mula also. The study of mula is through the bhashya. Otherwise, even anyone who studies only mula may not get whether it is advaita, dvaita, vishishta advaita, or is it pure logic. What is it? Some people have said that this advaita is same as the Upanishads talk about, same thing that Buddha spoke about. Completely opposite. Shunyavada has nothing to do with Purnatvam. That is revealed in the Shruti. So these misunderstandings are possible across the board because people study only Mula. So Bhashya studying bhashya we study through the bhashya we study the moola. Similarly, how do you study the bhashya? You study bhashya through the tika sampradaya. With the tika you studied, so with the vyakhya you studied. And now for vyakhya also we are studying vyakhya through the tika. Then tika can be studied with the tippana. So much is there. One can go to any granularity, but to say that I'll study only moola and then bhashya alone without looking into anything supporting the bhashya, that study is not bhashya study at all. So to claim that Bhagwan Bhashyakara did not say it is at odds with the learning. Anyway, I'm saying this because there are a lot of people who follow only bhashya and say that tika is not needed. So this is to buffer that, you know, it is not a defense, it is a justification for study of tika, and it is a justification for everything that is there in the sampradaya having value for some sadhaka or the other. Nonetheless, so what has been said? Mithya ajnana. Further, ubhaya vyavrutya, taking away both kinds of misunderstanding, swabhi matartha siddhaye. What is meant? What is the mind of Bhagavan Bhashyakara? To establish that, karmadharaya samasam vyutpadayati mithya chataditi. So, Ratna Prabhakara says, what is the mind of Bhagavan Bhashyakara there? He says, mithya chatadajnana, Ratna Prabha, mithya chatadajnanam cha mithya ajnanam. That is the samasa, karmadharaya samasa, but the split is mithya chatad ajnanam cha. Mithya and that which is ajnana. Tannimittam upadanam yasya. So what is the word in the moola, in the bhashya? It is mithya jnana nimittaha. So, loka vyavahara is mithya jnana nimitta. What is mithya jnana nimitta? It is bahuri. So, mithya chatajnanam is karmadharya and bahuri pada is mithya, that is mahuri with nimitta. So, mithya jnanam nimittam yasya loka vyavaharasya saha loka vyavahara mithya jnana nimitta loka vyavahara. So, tan nimittam upadanam yasya. What is nimittam there? Earlier, it was said as nimittasya naisargika padena uktatvat, and what is that? Nimitta karanam. Now the interpretation is further as to not only nimitta, really it is upadana karana, but Bhagavan Bhashyakara has added nimitta to show it is also nimitta karana. Meaning it is upadana karana as well as nimitta karana. Meaning it is material cause as well as ajnana is material cause as well as it is nimitta for what? Nimitta for. It is the cause for it. It is a sampradaya, sampradayata, parampara. There is a parampara of causes. Not only upadana karana, it is also nimitta. Nimitta here should be taken as nayayika's nimitta karana. So nayayika will say what is the nimitta karana there. Thereby it is also nimitta. Of course, Ishvara is what? Is abhinna nimitta upadana karana. Therefore, Ishvara along with his maya shakti, avidya shakti, Ishvara along with means nirguna brahma is not karana for anything. Athato brahma jidnyasa and then jagat karanatvam is talked about. There jagat karanatvam which is mentioned is that there it is not Shuddha Brahma which is Jagat Karana. So along with Maya there is Shuddha Brahma which becomes Ishvara, Saguna Brahma. So Nirguna Brahma cannot be Karana, Saguna Brahma is Karana. Who is Saguna Brahma? Nirguna Brahma along with Maya, Avidya. Therefore, Abhinna Nimitta Upadana Karana is not Shuddha Brahma, it is Ishvara. And in Ishvara what is the specialty? The specialty is this Maya Shakti, avidya shakti interchangeably. Thereby both nimitta and upadana are indicated by saying nimitta, whereas avidya should have been talked about only as upadana. Then why is it talked about nimitta by Bhagavan Bhashyakara? He says it is an indication that not upadana is understood, nimitta also should be taken. That is the reason he said mithya jnana nimittaha. So that mithyajna ajnana is also nimitta, not only upadana, also nimitta. Thereby what has been mentioned here in Ratnaprabha is tannimittaha, mithyajnana nimittaha is tadupadana. So nimitta meaning is also upadana, tadupadana ityartha. Tika mithyajnanam anirvachaniya mithya iti. What is mithya earlier? Mithya iti bhavitum yuktam. There mithya word meant nasti, not there. But here mithya does not mean nasti, it means anirvachaniya. Sarasadbhyam anirvachaniya. So had the sarpa, in the Rajju sarpa, had sarpa been real, it would never go away. Had it been unreal, it would have never appeared. So sachet na badhyeta, asachet na pratiyeta. But there is a pratiti of sarpa, therefore it cannot be said to be asat. Then can sarpa be said to be, Rajju sarpa, can it be said to be sat? No, it is not sat. Why? Sachet na badhyeta. It would never go away, but it goes away. So since it goes away, it is not sat. And since it is, it appears, it is not asat. Then what is it? Sadasat bhyam anirvachaniya. What is anirvachaniya there? So mithya ajnanam anirvachaniya mithya iti artha. Mithya means anirvachaniya. So what is vachaniya? Means vachana yogya. Vachana yogya is vachaniya. Ajnana is not something that can be described completely as it is. So then is it meaning vachaniya means something that is, that can be described. Is it said avachaniya? It is not been mentioned as avachaniya, meaning it is not that something which cannot be described. Otherwise it would be avachaniya. It is not avachaniya. Then what does anirvachaniya mean? It is not nirvachaniya. It may not be completely idam ittham. In that manner, it cannot be expressed. So, nishchayena vaktum ayogyam. So, anirvachaniya. Nirvachaniya would mean nishchayena vachaniya. Definitely, it can be explained. As to sat or asat. Is it sat? Definitely you tell me. Is it sat or is it asat? This is the approach of Vaishnava Sampradaya also. So Ramanujacharya objects, raises so many doubts. So they say that seven objections have been raised against Advaita. All those are based on only single thing. If you look at the first objection itself, whether this ajnana is sat or asat, we have already said it is mithya, meaning anirvachaniya, nischeena vaktum ayogya. This avidya is mithya, nischeena vaktum ayogya. So anirvachaniya means it cannot be categorically said to be sat or asat. It is sadbhinna and asadbhinna. So if we tell you that it is sadbhinna, asadbhinna, you cannot ask me whether it is sat or asat. We have already told you it is not sat. Then is it asat? This is your problem. So Siddhanti tells the Purvapakshi, this is your problem. You want it categorized as sat and asat. There are some things which cannot be categorized just in a digital world. The world is analog. So there are shades of gray. You cannot say, tell me it is black or white. There are so many colors in between. There are so many shades of gray. How can I tell you which exactly it is? No, you have to tell me one of the two. And then they say that this is a dosha. Since you cannot say it is a black or white, therefore, since you say it is grey, it is a grey area, this is your dosha. It is not a dosha. It is as we have experienced, it is as everyone experiences, it is that which Shruti reveals. And still if you think that it is a flaw in your understanding. Yasya nasti swayam prajna shastram tasya karoti kim. Shastra cannot do anything if a person does not have his own prajna. Shastra can do hand-holding, but even with that hand-holding, one should be able to think. even after spoon feeding, if one is not able to understand Shastra, it is not a dosha of the Shastra. And we base our entire sampradaya, entire Advaita sampradaya bases itself in Shruti. Therefore, any dosha pointed out to in Advaita is actually not misinterpretation of Shruti, because they use other tools. They don't use Shruti. All of these use something other than Shruti. They use Shushka Tarka or Purana Ityadi as Pramana over and above the Shruti. They place it over and above the Shruti or Anubhava also. Like the Charvakas. Charvakas will just use Anubhava. Tarkikas will use Tarkikas. And Shruti goes secondary. Others anyway, Nastikas we don't care about. They are same as Charvakas, whereas the Vedantins, the new brand of Vedantins, who were not there earlier, who have come up after Bhagavan Shankaracharya, they are all reinventing what has already been refuted by Bhagavan Bhashyakara in other darshanas. Thereby, they are also hidden Tarkikas, Prachanna Tarkikas. So mithya, their mithya jnana, jnanam anirvachaniya mithya ityartha. Ajan lakshanaya nimitta padasya upadanam api artha ityaha. So one way to take nimitta as in mithya jnana nimitta loka vyavahara, their nimitta is not nimitta karana, upadana karana also, because upadana karana is understood, nimitta has been additionally added by Bhagavan Bhashyakara. Because when you talk about karana, when you say what is ghata karana, you don't think about Kulala immediately. What do you think about? When you say, you know, what is this pot made up of? So the Karana of the pot is not the potter. You don't say, oh, it is made of potter. You say it is made up of clay or gold or whatever, silver. What is it made up of? So what is the Karana of this pot? There you think about Upadana Karana. So Upadana Karana is understood, but Nimitta has been additionally added. Otherwise, if the Purvapakshi says, no, how can that be? Then we say, okay, we'll give you another way to interpret this. Ajal Lakshana. You don't give up Nimitta, but Karana has been mentioned. Nimitta means Karana. Therefore, Karana will also trigger something else in the mind. That is Upadana Karana. Oh, Nimitta is this, then what is the Upadana? Oh, that is the Upadana also by Ajal Lakshana. You hold on to Nimitta also and you bring in, because there is a word Karana, Nimitta means Karana, you bring in Upadana also. So, Nimitta will pull in Upadana by Ajal Lakshana. निमित्त पदस्य उपादानम अपि अर्थ इति आह तदुपादान इति मिथ्या ज्ञान उपादान इति वक्तव्य सति मिथ्या ज्ञान निमित्त इति उक्ति उक्ति किमर्थ इत्यतः आह अज्ञानस्य इति देन पूर्व पक्षी सेज दैट देन हैड इट बीन उपादान देन भगवान भाष्यकार शुड हैव सेड उपादान व्हाई डिड ही से मिथ्या ज्ञान निमित्त अयम लोक व्यवहार नैसर्गिक अयम लोक व्यवहार ही कुड हैव सेड मिथ्या ज्ञान उपादान He could have made the Bahuri using Upadana Pada instead of Nimitta. So there, Ratna Prabhakara says, Ajnana se Upadana tve api. Although Ajnana is Upadana, Samspurad Atma Tattvavarakataya Doshatvena Ahankara Adhyasa Kartuhu Ishwarasya Upaditvena Samskara Kala Karmadi Nimitta Parinamitvena cha Nimittatvam iti Jyotayitum Nimitta Padam. Why did Bhagavan Bhashyakara not say Upadana, Mithyajnana Upadana Ayam Loka Vyavahara? Why did he not use Upadana instead of Nimitta? It is because he is talking about three Hetus when he brings in Nimitta. What are the three Hetus? Hetus in a sense? Tarka Hetus. Sadhana. So he is indicating something more. Ajnanasya upadanatvi api. Ajnana is upadana, is understood. We have explained this earlier. There is an adhyasa sampradaya which is not possible without ajnana. So that has been mentioned or indicated. Other than that, what do we want to mention? We want to talk about more. We want to talk about three hetus. What are those? Ajnanasya upadanatvi api. Samspurad atma. Atma tattva. What is Atma Tattva? The Pratyagatma is Brahma. Pratyagatma itself is not known by anyone who is not a Darshanika. So the real नेचर ऑफ द आत्मा, स्वरूप ऑफ द आत्मा इज नॉट नोन, विच इज इन द एंड रिवील्ड एज ब्रह्म बाय द श्रुति. बट एटलीस्ट लेट द मिक्सअप गो. ईच ऑफ द दार्शनिकास वॉन्ट्स टू सेपरेट आउट दैट आत्मा फ्रॉम द अनात्मा. Therefore, at least that should take place for each and every darshanika. So the Atma, which is Swayam Prakash Atma, Samspurad Atma, that Atma itself is hidden. Due to what? The same avidya jnana. So Samspurad Atma Tattva Avarakataya, there is an Avarana. This Avarana Shakti is there in avidya. Or avidya is of the nature of आवरण शक्ति एंड विक्षेप शक्ति. सो आवरण शक्ति इज इंडिकेटेड, दैट इज निमित्त. यू कैनॉट हैव अध्यास इफ आत्मा इज फुल्ली नोन. इफ स्वयं प्रकाश आत्मा इज कंप्लीटली नोन एज इज नोन टू अ ज्ञानी, विद्वत अनुभव इज देर, देन यू कैनॉट हैव आवरण अगेन. यू कैनॉट हैव विक्षेप टेकन एज रियल. विक्षेप मे बी देर बट इट विल नॉट बी टेकन एज रियल. You won't take the samsarana as real. You won't take the janma as real. You won't take the dukkha, the bandha as real. Therefore, although ajnana is upadana, it also has shakti to veil the atma swarupa. And since atma swarupa veiling becomes a nimitta for vikshepa, adhyasa, that is also indicated. Therefore, nimitta word has been used. One reason. And that's a dosha. Samspurad atma tattvavarakataya doshatvena. Due to that dosha being there in avidya, it becomes nimitta, meaning avarana dosha is there. Avarana karana dosha is there in the, which is what? Avaraka. Avaraka is avarana karanam. So avaraka dosha is there in avidya or ajnana. Therefore, that dosha becomes nimitta for vikshepa and tadatmya sambandha. So that is one hetu indicated by nimitta pada in mithya jnana nimittaha. Then ahankara adhyasa kartuhu ishvarasya upadityena. This ishvara causes this samsarana for the jiva based on jiva's karma, purva karma. Therefore ahankara adhyasa kartuhu, who makes this vikshepa identification, who wields this maya shakti and causes this samsarana for the jiva, who gives this janmadi in a particular sharira, Ishvara does it because he is karma phala data. Being karma phala data, Ishvara is what? Ahankara adhyasa karta. Not for himself, for the others. So he remains happily free, whereas he helps the others get what they want by actually pushing them into those kind of shariras. So ahankara sambandha is retained because their avidya is there and they want to continue. So he lets them do that. He helps them do that really. If they want to get away, then he helps them get away also. But ahankara adhyasa, ahankara is an adhyasa, ahankara tadatmya sambandha is an adhyasa, therefore ahankara adhyasa karta, who is that? It is Ishvara. I did not do it, Ishvara did this. So we say that Ishvara helped us. We take janma because we have avidya. So avidya is karana. What is this avidya? It is maya shakti of Ishvara. So Ishvara has this maya shakti, and with that avidya shakti, maya shakti meaning avidya shakti, ajnana shakti, he becomes ahankara adhyasa karta. He becomes srishti sriti laya karana. Not only jagat karana, jagat karana means srishti sriti laya karana. Tajjalana, Chandogya Upanishad says tajjalana. So janmadhyasya yataha, when you say in the sutra, that does janma adi is there. So janma adi is what? So not only srishti, sthiti and laya. So ahankara adhyasa karta, how did Ishvara become brahma? Ishvara is brahma. How did this nirguna brahma, shuddha brahma become jagat karta? Never became so. by maya. So maya is to explain. Maya is what? It is inferred. By the Shruti itself it is inferred. But then it is still inferred based on the karya. Karyanumeya maya. Bhagavan Bhashyakara, Bhagavat Padacharya says this in Viveka Chudamani. He says, what is maya? Maya is also not really there. Maya is not different from Ajnana. What is it? Maya is avidya. What is it? It is Ishvara Shakti. Why do you say it is there? It is Karyanumya. Prapancha, if you say Prapancha is there, then Prapancha cannot come from Shuddha Brahma, Nirguna Brahma. Nirguna Brahma cannot have Karanatvam, Jagat Karanatvam, Sthiti Karanatvam, Shrishti Karanatvam, Sthiti Karanatvam, Laya Karanatvam. That cannot be there in Nirguna Brahma because these are gunas which will not be there in Nirguna. So Nirguna Brahma is not Karana, Shuddhatva. What will happen then? How did this Karya come about? There is some Karana and there is none other than Brahma. Therefore, something has to be inferred. Some guna has to be inferred to make this Nirguna Brahma Saguna. So that Nirguna Brahma remains free from Jagat Kartrutvam. And you bring in a third element and then to explain the Karya, Karana who is there cannot be said to be Karana. So you have to drag in something else. That dragging in which is inferred because Nirguna Brahma cannot be a Karana for Jagat. Jagat is Karya. Then who is Karana? There is none other than Brahma. Therefore Brahma has to be Karana. Then how did that Nirguna become Karana? So you have to bring in a third element, which is a mithya element. You bring in maya to explain. You as in not any of the sampradayikas, but Shruti herself brings it. So when Bhagavad Padacharya says karyanumeya maya, through karya maya is anumeya, is inferred to be there. Anyatha anupapatya, without that there cannot be nirguna brahma becoming karana. So sagunatva has to be inferred and sagunatvam can be inferred along with maya or with avidya shakti only. Therefore maya is karyanumeya. Now this maya avidya is what? Is what makes Brahma Ishvara. Therefore becoming an upadhi, ajnana itself becomes an upadhi of Ishvara, which we call as maya. Maya is the upadhi of Ishvara, which upadhi of Ishvara means makes Brahma, upadhi of Brahma, whereby he gets the name tag as, it gets the name tag as Ishvara and becomes he, she, whatever you want to call her, the devata, Ishvara as. Thereby, ahankara adhyasa kartu Ishvarasya upadhitvena. Since it is an upadhi for Ishvara, therefore also ajnana is nimitta. Nimitta for what? Ahankara adhyasa. Otherwise, ahankara sambandha, tadatmya sambandha for jivas won't be possible. Ishvara enables it, becomes a nimitta. How did Ishvara become the nimitta? By ajnana shakti. Therefore, ajnana is nimitta also. This is the second hetu whereby nimitta word has been used by Bhagavan Bhashyakara in Mithya Jnana Nimitta. What is the third hetu? The third hetu here is samskara kala karmadi nimitta parinamitvena cha. So let's just take the example case of Rajju Sarpa. What do we say? That Sarpa is not only Jnana Adhyasa, it is also Artha Adhyasa. Sarpa Jnana alone is not Adhyasa, but Sarpa Vishaya is also there. Artha is there outside. Had it been only Jnana Adhyasa, what is Jnana Adhyasa? Sarpa Jnana is Adhyasa. Meaning Sarpa Jnana is a Brahma. So what is a Brahma? Somebody sees it in the Antakkarana. If somebody sees it in the Antakkarana, then one will know that I am seeing in the Antakkarana. Oh, I see Sarpa. When I see Sarpa outside, not within. One does not say I am imagining Sarpa. One says that I see Sarpa outside. Therefore, in Anirvachaniya Khyati, this Khyati will come up later, but Anirvachaniya Khyati, Vedanta, Advaita Vedanta takes to Anirvachaniya Khyati. Why is there Sarpa Brahma? Because Sarpa, Jnana, Brahma is there and Sarpa Vishaya Brahma is also there. There is Sarpa seen as real outside. And since it is seen outside, there should be sarpa outside. What kind of sarpa? Anirvachaniya sarpa. So there is an anirvachaniya utpatti of sarpa. There is sad vilakshana and asad vilakshana sarpa utpatti outside. Utpatti is itself anirvachaniya. But there has to be a sarpa accepted outside. Had it been outside vyavaharikataya, then others would have also seen it. But only a certain category sees, therefore it is not sat. But this person does not see it inside also, sees outside. Therefore it is outside as well. And it goes away, therefore it is not sat also. So sadvilakshana, asadvilakshana and bahya. Bahya deshe sarpa vartate. That is anirvachaniya sarpa, it is vishaya, it is arthadhyasa. Now, what is being said, the third is samskara kala karmadi nimitta. We are saying, we are extending rajju sarpa to the aham manushya, aham karta, aham bhokta ityadi and say that that is also rajju sarpavat brahma. Ahankaradi tadatmya sambandha is a brahma. I am not ahankara because Shruti says that you are brahma. I am Brahma, aham Brahma asmi. I cannot be manushya ityadi. Deha dharmas cannot be mine. I cannot be deha. So dharmi adhyasa and dharma adhyasa both are there. And I do karma ityadi. Why? Because ragadveshas are there. Samskaras are there. I do karma. There is bhoga. Bhoga makes me karta again via samskara. And there is a sampradaya which we saw in the last part. Samskara kala karmadi nimitta parinamitvena cha. Then what is this entire ahankaradi prapancha? Like sarpa is anirvachaniya sarpa. Similarly, if you really see, what is this manushyatvam, aham manushyatvam? This is all a brahma. So jnanadhyasa and arthadhyasa both are there. Ahankaradi are there. Are they real? No. Are they unreal? No. So sadasad vilakshana ahankaradi prapancha is there. Sadasad vilakshana ahankaradi prapancha jnana is there. Both arthadhyasa and jnanadhyasa are there in vyavaharika also. So vyavaharika will finally be collapsed into pratibhasika. Mithyatvena. Mithyatvena, when you say it is mithya, it is anirvachaniya, then it is not sat. Therefore, vyavaharika and pratibhasika differentiation, although we do, still for the sake of swarupa jnana, you have to collapse it into one. Finally, all this will be proven as brahma because it will become badhita. What is badhita is a brahma, it cannot be real. So, the mithya lakshana will come up further. So, that is the third reason. Samskara kala karmadi nimitta parinamitvena. The avidya itself undergoes parinama and becomes rajju vishaya, sarpa vishaya outside. Similarly, ahankaradi is what upadana converts itself into there is a parinama into ahankaradi prapancha. Maya undergoes a change. So that is upadana karanatvam also there. However, samskara kala karmadi nimitta, during the samskara kala, there is karmadi nimitta. So anyway, this samasa will be explained in the tika. Parinamitvena cha nimittatvam. As a causing parinama also, there is ajnana which is nimitta. Iti dyotayitum nimitta padam. So nimitta padam has also been used for these three reasons. I'll just look at the tika, which is, I'll just quickly go through this. Ahankara adhyasa. So why upadana has not been mentioned and nimitta has been mentioned, that is mentioned in the, that is elaborated in the Ratna Prabha as to three more hetus. Ahankara adhyasa kartuhu asmadadhya ahankara adhyasa kartur ityartha. So Ishvara is ahankaradi ahankara adhyasa kartu. Ahankaradi adhyasa kartu. What is that ahankara adhyasa? Ahankara adhyasa is not for Ishvara, it is for others. So he is a karayita really. So karta by what? By tadhetu. So in Vyakrana also, Svatantra karta and then tadhetu prayojakascha. So he is a prayojaka hetu. He is a hetu for the ahankara karta to become karta. So ahankara adhyasa and adhyasatvena karta, for that Ishvara is the nimitta. Ahankara adhyasa and Ishvara is nimitta, meaning with ajnana is nimitta, therefore ajnana is nimitta. परंपरा है। अहंकार अध्यास कर्तु अस्मद अस्मदादि अहंकार अध्यास कर्तु इत्यर्थः। इदम् उपलक्षणम् ईश्वरस्य सर्व जगत कर्तृत्वम् उपाधिं विना न संभवति इति ईश्वरनिष्ठ कर्तृत्वाद्युपाधित्वेन इत्यर्थः। सो ईश्वर इज ऑल्सो कर्ता, यू कैन नॉट से ईश्वर इज नॉट कर्ता, ही जगत कर्ता। सो ईश्वर मे नॉट हैव भ्रमा बट ही इज कर्ता टू कॉज भ्रमा फॉर अदर्स। सो ही इज नॉट अफेक्टेड बाय हिज माया और अविद्या, वेर एज फॉर अदर्स दे गेट इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय माया और अविद्या। सो ही हैज बिकम जगत कर्ता। So Ishvara himself becomes Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva by upadhi bhedas, by taking particular roles. So he has a job to do. Therefore, at least that much kartrutvam has to be accepted in Ishvara. So idam upalakshanam Ishvara se jagat kartrutva, sarva jagat kartrutvam upadhim vinana sambhavati. Without that upadhi, maya upadhi, avidya upadhi, ajnana upadhi, it isn't possible. Iti Ishvara nishta kartrutvad upadhitvene icharta. Ishvara has kartrutva as an upadhi which is due to ajnana, which is not binding on him, but still that maya upadhi, avidya upadhi has to be taken, kartrutva upadhi has to be taken. Samskara kala karmajini yani nimittani tat parinamitvena iti vigraha. So the samasa vigraha is explained as to what is this samskara kala karmadi nimitta parinamitvena in Ratna Prabha. That is samskara kala karmadini, the karma etc. which are there in samskara kala, meaning samskara janya karmas which are going on in that kala, yani nimittani, those nimittas which are there tat parinamitvena. So ajnana itself transforms into that kind of a nimitta iti vigraha. अज्ञानस्य मायात्वेन उपादानत्वं दोषत्वेन इत्यादि तृतीयात्रयेण निमित्तत्वं अपि अस्ति इति ज्ञापयितुं निमित्तपदमिति भावः। सो व्हाट इज द आइडिया, ऑल द थ्री हेतुस आर देयर फॉर भगवान भाष्यकर टू यूज द वर्ड निमित्त इंस्टेड ऑफ उपादान इन मिथ्या ज्ञान निमित्त। अज्ञानस्य मायात्वेन उपा एटसेट्रा इति भावः। दिस इज द स्वप्रकाश फॉर दैट, दिस इज द संगति। सो वी लुक एट संगति एंड दी नेक्स्ट पार्ट इन दी नेक्स्ट पार्ट। यम ह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरी सहोदराप महत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनक चांकमनंत सुखाकृतिं। शतिनी क्वेश्चंस के नमस्ते।